funny how the story goes. Little hope, but bigger dreams. They try to bring a sucker down, singing louder than the crowd.
Good morning, guys. Welcome to today's What I Eat in a Day. As you saw, I've already had a very busy morning. It is currently only 8 a.m. and I have been to the gym, did my strength training workout, did my 30 minutes on the elliptical. I actually just finished my coffee and I didn't show you what was in my coffee. I plan on doing a video all about how I get protein in my coffee in the morning, but today my coffee was really simple. I did my collagen for her, collagen peptides, my Just Better fiber. I'll link both of those down below. And then today I actually put in the Core Power Elite 42 grams of protein shake because it was my strength training cardio day, which means that I'm burning a lot more calories and I'm needing that little extra bit of protein. There's 230 calories and again, 42 grams of protein. This is really good. I buy this at Sam's Club. I know that you can buy this on Amazon. So when I have a heavy workout day or if it's going to be a long time before I'm able to eat again and my coffee actually needs to sustain me for a while, I'll go ahead and use this one rather than the Alani or the regular Fairlife that are like 20 or 30 grams of protein. So coffee is finished. I am going to fill up my water. I'm using still those 4C water enhancers that I bought off of Nutrition. These are really, really good. I just ordered the Ultima ones off of Amazon. I'll link both down below for you. I'll link the 4C ones on Nutrition. I'll link the Ultima ones with electrolytes. Sometimes I just feel like I need to recoup some electrolytes, so I'll use the Ultima ones. And then I'll also link my water bottle, my Lululemon water bottle, because it's pretty amazing. And because I had the protein shake with all the protein, I'm not really eating breakfast. I'm going to have a mid-morning snack, and that should tide me over until lunch. So I have the Siggy's strawberry yogurt, 15 grams of protein, 11 grams of sugar, 110 calories, super good, really, really clean ingredients. I've been loving the Siggy's yogurt, and they were on sale at Sprouts, so I picked up quite a few. And then I have the Trader Joe's peanut butter protein granola. Let me just tell you how good that is with strawberry yogurt or berry yogurt. It's kind of like peanut butter and jelly. So I'm just going to weigh out 30 grams of the Trader Joe's peanut butter protein granola. You can also pick up the Nature Valley honey and oat protein granola. And there's one other one. I just figure if I'm going to put granola on my yogurt, I'm going to get in some extra protein. Speaking of protein, I did have a couple people request that I share the number of grams of protein in my meals. And then at the end of the day, how many grams of protein that I ate, because you know, I share points and calories. So I'm going to start doing that. I'm going to start letting you know how many grams of protein I'm eating in my meals and my snacks and how I'm reaching my protein goal every day in real time. So let's put together some yogurt for breakfast. So there is my breakfast. I mean, that's a lot of granola. So I have some Siggy's yogurt topped with 30 grams of protein granola. I have been working in my office all morning since I got ready, got home from the gym, had some breakfast. It is just about lunchtime, but lucky for me, Troy is actually heading out to go golfing today with his dad, which is a really good thing because he loves to golf and he hasn't been able to since moving to Arizona, and his dad invited him today. And it's lucky for me because I get the whole house to myself, which since moving has been quite the change. Troy was at work 4 days a week, 12 hours a day. He worked 4/10s when we lived in Washington, and now he's home all the time. I'm sure he agrees whenever we get a reprieve from each other for a little bit. It's kind of nice to just have the whole house to ourselves. I'm going to pack him a cooler with some drinks and some snacks because a round of golf can take several hours, and I want to make sure that he stays hydrated and that he has some snacks on hand. I just picked up two of these insulated coolers. I gave one to my father-in-law for Father's Day for golf, so he has his, I'm sure, with him today. And then I got one for us as well for golfing or for when we're out on road trips or for me if I'm out showing houses. I can make sure I pack healthy lunches and healthy snacks. So this is from the brand LifeWit, and this is the large insulated lunch bag. It is also a cooler tote bag. It is made of water-resistant fabric, and it has a PEVA foil interior liner. So it's really going to help keep your food nice and cold. It's a 15 liter capacity, which is enough to basically store 24 cans of Coke, and it's big enough to hold the essentials that a family needs for a picnic or for travel. I really like the wide opening because I'm able to put, you know, I'm able to put his meat stick in there and big bottles of water and Gatorade. It has one front pocket, two side pockets, and an adjustable shoulder strap, so you can either carry it on your shoulder or you can just carry it by the smaller handle, and it can be folded for easy storage. It comes in gray or black, and it also comes in the 15 liter size, which is the one that I have, and a 24 liter size, which is larger, and it's $20. $20 for the 15 liter size, and if you decide to get the larger one, it's $32.99, which would be great for large family picnics. I can't believe how affordable it was for how nice of quality is. My father-in-law and my mother-in-law loved it. In fact, my mother-in-law said, "Ooh, I can take this to pickleball or when I go to shuffleboard." It's in really handy again for camping, picnics, travel, and we will absolutely get a lot of use out of it when Troy goes golfing with his dad, and he also plays horseshoes with his dad 2 days a week as well, so that he can bring his drinks and snacks with him. So I'll go ahead and link the LifeWit lunch/cooler bag down below for you. So for lunch today, I'm actually going to have what I prepped in my meal prep. If you missed this week's meal prep, definitely check it out because this has been such a good lunch for me. So I prepped these lettuce wrapped BLTAs. So I have two slices of turkey bacon, some lettuce, tomato, a Laughing Cow cheese wedge, and then I'm putting some avocado, some raspberries, a hard boiled egg, and a pre-portioned out little pack of almond. You could also put this on a wrap or bread, whatever you want to do. But first thing I'm going to do is actually weigh out 30 grams of avocado. So there is 30 grams, which is actually almost an entire half of an avocado. And then to assemble my little wrap, I'm going to grab the lettuce. I like to warm up my bacon, so I'm going to throw my bacon in the microwave for a couple seconds. So the first thing I'm going to do is spread out my 30 grams of avocado. And then I have one wedge of Laughing Cow cheese. I'm going to put that on the lettuce wrap. And then I'm actually going to grab one more lettuce leaf just because this was a pretty small one. If I use a bigger leaf, I can usually wrap all that goodness up. But because this is a little bit smaller, I'm going to just add another layer of lettuce to the top. So I kind of have a little lettuce wrapped sandwich. Doesn't that look so good? So that is my lunch. Doesn't this look so good? I have some nuts for some added protein, healthy fats. I have my raspberries, my hard-boiled egg. Oh my gosh, this is such a good filling lunch. It's this little snack plate, like an adult Lunchable. It's so good and like crispy and refreshing. I love a good snack plate, a good adult Lunchable. I have quite the captive audience when I'm eating my lunch. I got this one here, Diesel's over here. He actually was begging a minute ago and I made him lay down. And then this one. Are you so tired, Bubba, you can't even get up? Yeah, he was a tired boy today. Hi, baby. Okay, I just finished my lunch. I'm gonna have a JoJo. These are the Trader Joe's Strawberry Lemonade JoJo's. You guys, these are so delicious. You can see we still have a lot left. I picked these up a couple weeks ago. That's a huge win for me. Number one, that there's still cookies left. And number two, that I can just have one cookie and move on. So this is going to round out my lunch. Pretty excited. It's time to do a little bit of home organization. From the brand LifeWit, same brand that the cooler bay came from, they actually sell refrigerator organizer bins. You get a set of 8 of them, and you don't have to just use these in your refrigerator. I actually use these bins in my bathroom, in my makeup vanity, in my pantry, just anywhere that I want to be able to organize. And these ones from LifeWit are super affordable. I love just the added touch of the design on them. They are the clear acrylic. They have handles on both sides. And like I said, they're perfect for the refrigerator, the pantry. I store my makeup in these. I have these under the sink in my bathroom. I mean, I really just use these everywhere in my house. And I love that these came in a set of 8. So one affordable price, 8 different storage containers. So today I want to focus on my refrigerator and my pantry. I have just a little bit more organizing to do since moving into our new house. And after I did some organization, all I had left for my fridge were skinny bins. And I actually wanted these a little bit larger ones just to help organize all those loose things that end up in your refrigerator. So we always have just a ton of different cheeses in our refrigerator at all times. You guys know this family loves cheese. So I definitely want to take one of the LifeWit bins and organize it with the cheese. And then we always have these little no sugar added fruit cups as well. And these are just loose items that roll around my refrigerator. And then all my fun little snack packs and things that I buy as well. So I'd like to have one of my LifeWit bins that stores my hard-boiled eggs, my snack packs, my cheese sticks, because like I said, things just roll around your refrigerator. They get lost in the back of your refrigerator. They fall down in between the cracks. So these bins just come in really super handy. That is so much better already. I already feel really good that everything's a little bit more organized. I just can't believe how these bins are really, really nice. So let me go ahead and do a little more organization in the fridge. I'll show you the final product and then we'll move into the pantry. So I ended up using one of the bins for the top here for my cottage cheese, Greek yogurt, and I will also put all of my single yogurts in that bin. I'm actually out of single yogurt right now. And then I do have one of the large bins that has the cheese, everything that you saw. And then I also put one of the bins down here so it's easy just to slide in and out. This has my hemp seeds, my flaxseed, my garlic, olives, all the stuff that I use all the time. That way I can just pull it out and get easy access to the items. It definitely looks a lot better and a lot more organized. Now I'm going to move into my pantry because I have all this space that could use some storage. I do have a couple other bins that I utilize a lot and I've been out of bins. So I'm going to put a couple more into this portion and then I think I may add a bin to this shelf as well. And potentially one that houses all of my supplements right next to all of my nut butter. Look how much better this looks. So I added 2 bins here. These are my crunchy snacks, rice cakes, crackers. I have my almonds and my dried fruit. And then I definitely needed a way to store my fiber gourmet pasta because I always buy it in bulk and I have like 10 boxes and they just fall over every time I open my pantry. So that bin comes in really handy for that. And then I did add a bin here where my supplements are. So my greens and my post-workout, my water enhancers, my protein water, powder, all of that is in a bin now too, which also just looks a lot nicer. I mean, everything is much more organized, easy to find things. You can just pull the bins out as you need things. I still have a couple of extra bins I can use elsewhere in my house. So the leftover bin I had, perfect in my little hallway organizing closet here. This is all of my body lotion. I know, I have a lot. I'm obsessed with Bath & Body Works body cream, but they always fall over. So again, the bin just comes in super handy. So for my snack this afternoon, I'm having my normal snack, which is one of the Sprouts brown rice rice cakes. I always say I like these ones because they're only 25 calories and they're really the perfect size for a snack. And then I'm also having nut butter, which is something I eat several times a day. I love the American Dream nut butter. I've shared this a lot here on my channel. It's always linked down in the description box with 10% off, but I'm having the One Tough Cookie cashew butter. This one has like chocolate chip cookies, Oreos, M&Ms, all mixed into it. That's what I love about the American Dream nut butter is all of the yummy mixins. It just makes the peanut butter or the cashew butter or almond butter way more fun. This one has 7 grams of protein, 10 carbs, and 10 fat for 2 tablespoons, but I'm just going to have 1 tablespoon. I just always weigh that out on my food scale. Look how good that looks. I mean, you can see the M&Ms and the cookies. And then I'm having a Babybel Gouda cheese. And like I always say, this is a really good snack option because we have a carb in the rice cake paired with a protein and healthy fat in the nut butter and some extra protein in the Babybel. Really is the perfect afternoon snack. For dinner tonight, I am making Caprese chicken and roasted vegetables. I have lots of vegetables I need to use up from my Imperfect Foods and my Misfit Market order, so we're going to roast those up. So first, let me show you the veggies. I'm doing broccoli, mushrooms, yellow squash, and zucchini, and then I have some Brussels sprouts. I'm going to season my vegetables, as always, with my Dax Green Zest. This is my favorite seasoning for vegetables. There is no salt. It is a nice, clean ingredient seasoning. It's a small business. I'll link them down below with 10% off for you. And then I'm going to do salt and pepper as well, and then drizzle some olive oil on top. And then for the chicken, you're going to need fresh basil, light mozzarella cheese, balsamic glaze. You could probably use balsamic vinegar, but I'm going to stick with the glaze. Some chicken, really good quality chicken from Imperfect Foods, by the way, so I'll make sure that that is linked down below for you as well, with $40 worth of free groceries. And then you'll need some fresh Roma tomatoes. I'm going to drizzle some olive oil just right on top of the veggies. Add my Dax Green Zest. I'm telling you, game changer for vegetables. So, so good, and no salt. So if you're watching your sodium, Dax is a great option. None of their seasonings have salt, but they have a ton of flavor. I'm going to add a little bit of pepper, and then I am going to add a little bit of salt as well. Veggies are going into a 400 degree oven to start roasting while we get ready to make the chicken. I'm going to go ahead and slice up the tomato for the chicken and the basil. And then we actually need to put our chicken between some saran wrap and kind of pound it out into thinner chicken pieces. So I have my chicken wrapped in some saran wrap. I do not have a mallet, so I'm just gonna use a coffee cup and bang it until I can get it as flat as possible. I sprayed my skillet with some nonstick cooking spray, added my chicken. I'm going to salt and pepper both sides, and we're going to allow it to cook until we get a little bit of a brown on the chicken. It should take about 6 to 7 minutes. Once the chicken is done, we're going to drizzle 1/3 cup of balsamic glaze right on top. Top it with some fresh tomatoes. And I have 1/2 cup of mozzarella cheese. I did go ahead and turn the heat off as well because it should be warm enough to melt the cheese. The chicken is done. This looks so delicious. We're going to top it with some fresh basil. I'm pulling the veggies out. Let me plate this up and I'll be back to share points and calories. So here is dinner. This looks so good. There is the Caprese chicken. The recipe makes 3 servings. I'm going to only eat half of this chicken breast and save the other half. That'll make the 3rd serving. I did end up taking the thicker, bigger chicken breast. And then I have some of the roasted vegetables, Brussels sprouts, mushrooms, squash, zucchini, and broccoli. So I'll go ahead and put points, calories here on the screen. As I promised last week, I want to share with you guys my new kitchen gadget that I'm really obsessed with. I've been using it pretty much every single night. This is the Ninja Creami. So this is the ice cream maker. We've been trying out all sorts of recipes. I mean, there are Facebook groups dedicated to this machine, and I love it. Best decision ever to purchase this. I'll link it down below for you. I found it the cheapest at Bed Bath & Beyond, so I'll put all the information down below for you. But I have my ice cream softening for about a minute or so in the microwave, and I'm gonna show you how amazing this is. So when you purchase the Ninja Creami, it comes with three of these little pints. So you do have to make your ice cream base 24 hours in advance. So I actually made these bases yesterday, and then they stay in the freezer until you're ready to make them into ice cream. I have been making protein ice cream, which has been really a game changer for me. It's a great way for me to not only get dessert, but to also get some extra protein. So this particular one is an Alani Munchies protein shake and 2 tablespoons of PB2. And then I put in about a half a teaspoon to a teaspoon of Xanthum Gum, which is a thickener. And that's just going to help it make a perfect ice cream. Like I said, I've been experimenting. I've used vanilla protein shakes. I've used protein powder. I also used the Fairlife shakes. I mean, there's so many different things that you can do. You can add mixins like chocolate chips and nuts. I mean, the possibilities are endless. I'm going to list a couple of my favorite protein ice cream recipes down in the description box for you, as well as this one that I'm making tonight for dessert. And that way you have a couple ideas for some protein ice cream. And if you have the Ninja Creami and you make protein ice cream, let us know some of your favorite recipes. So we're actually going to put the pint into the little container. It actually looks like a little mini food processor container. And the blade for your ice cream is actually in the lid. So then we're going to put the lid on and then set it in the base and twist it to the right and see how it's raising and it locks into place. And then you're actually ready to make your ice cream. So you can see that there's lots of settings. Ice cream, sorbet, light ice cream, smoothie bowl, gelato, milkshake, and then this mix-in button. After you spin your ice cream, if you want to add something to it, like cookies or chocolate chips, you would use the mix-in button and it gives it kind of a quick stir and really mixes it in. So I'm not going to add anything to mine. I've had this one before and it's really good by itself. So I do spin all of my protein ice cream with the light ice cream button. Almost done. It is loud. There we go. We are done. So this little button right here actually releases the container, and then you just spin it down, pop it out, and there's a release button here for the lid. And ready? Are you ready for the magic? Look at that. That is legit ice cream. Look at the consistency. So the Xanthum Gum really helps make it nice and thick like ice cream. I mean, can we just admire how amazing that looks? Like I said, this is seriously one of my favorite things. Once you spin it, if you don't eat the whole pint, you can put it back in the freezer. You don't have to re-spin it. I mean, you can, but if you just let it thaw for just a couple minutes, it goes right back to that ice cream consistency. It's so good. It's chocolatey, it's peanut buttery, it's nice and thick, and it has that perfect creamy texture and taste. This entire pint is less than 200 calories, which is incredible, and over 20 grams of protein, 25 grams-ish of protein. So like I said, it's a great way to have a sweet treat, get in your protein. I'm definitely going to enjoy every drop of this tonight. So I'm going to take a shower, wash my hair. Tomorrow's my filming day, so I'm gonna get ready for filming, and then I'm going to enjoy the rest of my ice cream from the Ninja Creami. Highly, highly, highly recommend. It is so good, and like I said, there's so many different variations that you can make and try out different types of ice cream. Troy's been having the regular ice cream, like the full fat one, and it is really, really delicious. So I'll link everything I shared with you down in the description box, and if you enjoyed today's video, give it a big thumbs up. It really helps out my channel. And of course, make sure you're subscribed and your bell's turned on, because I upload 5 days a week and Wednesday's always What I Eat in a Day. I'll link everything down below with nutrition coaching, all the other links to my favorite things. And don't forget, we'd love to have you join our Facebook community. Happy Wednesday, friends, and I'll see you in Friday's weigh-in. Bye.